Hi, I'm Mai and I'm a product manager for Google Meet. Today, I'm really excited to announce that your users will be able to connect and engage with your app through Google Meet with a new feature called live sharing. First, I'll speak a little to why we're focused on shared experiences in Google Meet. Next, I'll cover how we're enabling you to bring these shared experiences to your users. Then I'll tell you how your users will discover the feature. And then Viraj, a PM on the YouTube team, will come in and tell you about what this feature looks like in YouTube and give you a glimpse of what the team did to integrate with Meet. We'll end with details on how you can join our early access program and try out the SDK yourselves, which we hope you'll want to do by the time you finish watching this session. All right, let's dive in. First, let's take a step back and talk about why shared experiences are even important to us right now. Why would this be an area that is exciting to bring to users? And why do we believe this would help you bring a new dimension to your app? Here's a great quote by John Dewey that says, "Things gain meaning when used in a shared experience or joint action." And when we think about why that might be true, it's because human bonds are formed through shared experiences. Doing things together, sharing things with each other, are such critical elements in establishing and nurturing relationships. And that, in turn, is the foundation of being human. So sharing experiences is something humans gravitate towards and find rewarding, naturally. But of course, like everything else in life and the world, what sharing experiences actually looks like changes with time. And most recently, this area has changed really fast, accelerated by the global pandemic and being physically apart. Some of these trends were already becoming apparent even before the pandemic because people are more mobile now and travel has become both easier and more accessible. Alongside this, or partly because of this, technology has evolved and of course will continue to evolve to make connecting across geographies easier and better. We have seen people address these changes by stitching their own solutions together. For example, texting while watching a show together, playing a song while on a video call, group chatting while watching a basketball game. And so we see this moment as both a challenge and an opportunity to make that shared experience easier, more seamless, more fun. After all, Google Meet's mission is to help strengthen social connections. So we set out to build a platform that enables developers like you to do just that. And with that, I'm super excited to announce Meet Live Sharing. Today, we will showcase how you can bring your users together in new, easy, and exciting ways by integrating your app with Google Meet. You may be thinking, hey, that sounds cool, but what is this live sharing actually? So let me tell you. Live sharing is a combination of Meet's State Sync API, plus the operating system's picture-in-picture, or PIP for short, that allows for real-time synced content and shared controls across devices for your users. This makes the experience for your users look and feel as if they were really together, deepening connections and sharing moments, all right inside your app. This feature will work across all the major platforms, Android, iOS, and the web. And it even works with Chromecast. So your users can cast your app's content onto the big screen while still connecting with their friends and family over Meet. More than anything, we want you to meet your users where they are and wherever their friends may be. So let me share a little bit about each of these components. Our new State Sync API will let you sync your app's content across devices and platforms. Meet will serve as the backbone to your distribution of app-specific metadata. We built a transport mechanism for you in such a way so that what you send and receive is opaque to us. And this gives you the maximum flexibility to tailor the experience for your users based on variables that you set. By using our API to sync state across devices, you users will be seeing the same content at the same time and have shared controls across everyone in the Meet. So for example, when someone pauses, the content is paused for everyone. Or when someone chooses something new to share, everyone sees the new content at the same time. But the shared element of the experience goes beyond sharing controls and content selection. Your users will be able to see and engage with their friends and family throughout all of this because of Google Meet. We make this possible by leveraging the OS level picture-in-picture, and this lets your users see their loved ones over video while still leaving maximum real estate on the device for your content. All right, so now that I've talked about what the components of live sharing are, the next question would be, well, where is this going to show up? And how would my users discover live sharing? Fear not. We've worked really hard to make sure your users will find live sharing once you integrate our SDK. In fact, there are three entry points to the experience. The first two can be found by users while they're in a Meet call, and the third one is found in your app's UI. So let me tell you a little bit about each one of those. In the first entry point, a user is in a video call and finds your app listed in our activities menu. They can then click through and begin live sharing from there. If they either don't have your app or any other conditions you want your users to meet, such as a specific tier or some kind of premium status, the user will be prompted to install the app in the App Store and we would deep link them there, or they will be asked to upgrade to the tier that you asked for. Quick side note here, this is a really great way to get new users into your app. When your current users are live sharing with their friends and family, they'll be prompted to install your app if they don't already have it. All right, so in the second entry point, the user is also in a video call already, and in this case also knows that your app supports live sharing. This is most relevant to those users who have already used the feature in your app and are coming back for another time. In this case, they can skip the activities menu, navigate directly to their home screen, find your app, and go to live sharing from there. In the third entry point, the user is simply browsing their phone, finds your app and some cool content, and so wants to start sharing it with someone they know. They can enter the experience directly from a button that you put into your UI. This button will spin up a link for a video call that the user can then share with others to begin a live sharing experience. All right, so I've let you know about our exciting new feature and all the ways your users can discover it. I'm also excited to let you know that we've already been working with a few early partners who are integrating our SDK in preparation for our launch in their apps later this year. That's been really fun to do. And so we thought for you to really get a sense of live sharing, it's easiest to see what it looks like when it's already integrated. For that, I'm excited to pass it on to Virash from the YouTube team. He will show you how YouTube has integrated Meet live sharing and will give you some insight into what it takes to build it yourself. Take it away, Virash.
Hi, I'm Virash, a product manager at YouTube. We're really excited about partnering with Google Meet to enable our viewers to watch YouTube together. I'll walk you through how YouTube is using Meet live sharing and how you can get started. Meet is a natural partner for YouTube, allowing us to meet our users where they are, in video calls with their friends and family. Users will need a YouTube Premium subscription to initiate a Meet live share. YouTube Premium lets users immerse in the content they love without in-stream ads. Once a premium member starts a Meet live share, everyone in the call can join in and watch together, even without a membership. If users are already in a call, they can use the Meet Activities menu to jump to YouTube and start watching together. Every user watches in their own YouTube app, so they can use the features they love, like home, search, and saved videos, to find something to watch together. Users can also navigate on their own to the YouTube app and use the share menu to start watching together. And finally, users can use the share menu to start a new call and invite their friends to watch with them. Perfect for when they find that hilarious new video and want to see their friends' reactions. Next, let's talk about what you need to do to support live share in your app. First, you'll need to initialize the Meet Coactivity library. This gives you an instance of a Meet client, which is how you'll connect to the meeting and enable users to watch together. Using the Meet client, you can join the Coactivity and set up your handlers to respond to changes in the meeting status, as well as synchronize user activity. Meeting State Handler allows you to get notified when the meeting state changes and then respond appropriately. For example, when another user in the meeting starts an activity, you'll want to respond to that by prompting the current user to join. When the meeting ends, you'll need to end the session, including any cleanup that's required for your app. Next, you want to make sure that the actions the current user takes are reported to Meet so that they can be broadcast to everyone on the call and keep things in sync. For YouTube, this includes actions such as pausing, resuming, seeking, and adjusting the playback speed. You'll need to use the Meet co-watching instance you created during initialization to do this. The opposite scenario is responding to an action that another user takes. You'll be notified about their actions through the co-watching controller and need to update the app state to respond. For example, if one user pauses playback, you'll want to pause the current user's playback to keep things in sync. Note that automatically adjusting to a user's action isn't always the right thing to do. For example, video streaming apps may want to allow a small amount of slack in the synchronization. Seeks may cause the user's playback to buffer, so you should only seek to the current position when the user has fallen significantly behind. All right, let's sum up. Meet Live Sharing unlocks new experiences in your app, and it's a great way to bring your users together. A great benefit for developers is reaching new audiences and providing more value to users. And lastly, it's easy to adopt the new SDK. So if you'd like to join YouTube in integrating with Meet Live Sharing, join the Early Access Program.